Ah, death. One of life's great mysteries. Despite huge advances in science and medicine, we're no better at predicting the exact date and time of our own death than a carnival fortune teller would be. While we may not be able to predict when any one individual person will die, we have certainly come a long way in understanding the life expectancy for entire populations, and everyone from insurance companies to medical researchers rely on this information to make important decisions every day. Understanding life expectancy around the world, throughout history, and even into the future can help us all make better decisions about our daily lives, too. So, when will you die? Find out, if you dare. We're certainly lucky to live in a time when global life expectancy is at an all-time high. The average person alive on Earth today can expect to live up to the ripe old age of 73. Women have it a bit better with an average life expectancy of 75 and a half years, while men can expect to live just under 71 years. But that's global life expectancy. If we take a closer look at different countries individually, we can see that life expectancy varies quite a bit around the world, even today. The region with the best life expectancy today is Hong Kong, where the average woman can expect to live for a whopping 88 years, and men have a life expectancy of 82 years for an average of 85 years for both sexes. Most developed countries have an average life expectancy of over 75 years. Australians live an average of nearly 84 years, Canadians can expect to stick around for almost 83 years on average, and Americans have a life expectancy of about 79 years. Less developed countries unfortunately have a much lower life expectancy. In the Central African Republic, the region with the lowest life expectancy in the world, the average life expectancy is just 54 years. Somalians can expect to live 58 years on average, and people living in Haiti have an expectancy of 65 years. When we're talking about how long someone will live, it's important that we understand the difference between life expectancy and lifespan. The figures we just went over are averages for life expectancy. Life expectancy is the average number of years of life for an entire population, taking into account how long each individual person actually lived. Lifespan, on the other hand, is the actual length of any given individual's life. For example, while the average life expectancy in the year 1200 AD might have only been 35 years, does that mean that most people back then only lived to be 35? Of course not. Life expectancy is calculated from birth, and that figure includes rates of infant mortality and childhood deaths. In ancient times, before the advent of modern medicine, the likelihood of dying during birth or in early childhood was much, much higher, and these early deaths dragged down the average life expectancy for the whole population. For every child who's died as a baby, another person could have lived to see their 70th birthday. But when all these individual lifespans are taken together, the average life expectancy lands somewhere in the middle, around 30 to 40 years. Hong Kong, which currently boasts the highest life expectancy in the world, also has some of the lowest infant and child mortality rates, with just 1.2 infant deaths per 1,000 live births, and only 1.9 deaths per 1,000 children under 5. In the US, these numbers are a bit higher at 5.5 infant deaths per 1,000 and 5.7 deaths per 1,000 in children under 5. But even these numbers are nothing compared to the Central African Republic, which has 71 infant deaths per 1,000 live births and 106 deaths out of every 1,000 children under 5. When we factor in infant and child mortality, it's easy to see why the Central African Republic has the world's lowest life expectancy. Factors like access to medical care, disease, war, famine, and natural disasters all contribute to lower infant, child, and adult life expectancies. We may be currently living in an age of all-time highs for life expectancy, but it definitely wasn't always this way. In 1950, just 70 years ago, the global life expectancy was just 47 years, and in the US it was only slightly better at 68 years. If we go back a little further, the average life expectancy in Europe in 1800 was between 30 and 40 years. The same factors that account for the vast differences in life expectancy between countries today is to blame for the low life expectancy in the past. Access to medical care, war, famine, disease, and high infant and child mortality. Infant mortality rates are also improving around the world. In 1921, even countries like Canada had a 10% infant mortality rate. So as these numbers improve, the average life expectancy increases, especially in developed nations. So now that we understand the difference between life expectancy and lifespan, and have learned a bit about life expectancy around the world and throughout history, let's take a look at the really important question. When will you die? In other words, what is your personal expected lifespan? There are a few major factors at play when calculating your personal life expectancy. Obviously, the country you're born in plays a huge role, as we've already seen. Gender is another big one. You might have noticed earlier that the life expectancy data always seem to favor women. In the US, women can expect to live to 81, while men have a life expectancy of just 76 years. Some researchers chalk this up to the fact that men are more likely to engage in riskier behaviors than women, making them more likely to die an accidental death. Genetics is another big factor in your life expectancy. 9 of the 10 leading causes of death in the US currently are directly linked to genetics. If you have a family history of heart disease, cancer, diabetes, Alzheimer's, or other hereditary diseases, your life expectancy might be lower than average. Thankfully, advances in medical care have boosted life expectancy in recent decades, thanks to innovations like antibiotics, immunizations, surgery, and medical imaging. Medical conditions that would have been life-threatening just a few generations ago are now largely treatable thanks to advances in modern medicine. Things like your country of birth, your gender, and your genetics are largely up to fate. But what about factors that are within your control? Is there anything you can do to impact your life expectancy? Thankfully, the science says yes. Education level has a shocking impact on life expectancy. While not everyone is lucky enough to be able to go to college, if you can manage it, it might actually help you live longer. American men with only a high school education live an average of 9.3 years less than those with a bachelor's degree or higher. For women, a bachelor's degree increases their life expectancy by 8.6 years. Better get studying. This one might surprise you, but married people actually live longer than single, divorced, or widowed people. This may be due to the fact that married people are less lonely and isolated, and having a partner might motivate you to take better care of yourself by living a healthy lifestyle and seeking medical care. Who knew a nagging spouse was good for your health? Of course, there are plenty of everyday lifestyle decisions that we make that can have a huge impact on our lifespan. Eating a healthy diet, exercising regularly, avoiding smoking, and limiting drinking are all great ways to improve your health and increase your lifespan. Avoiding risky behaviors and ensuring a safe work environment and safe driving habits can also help. Data shows that socioeconomic status also plays a role here. Those with higher incomes are more likely to exercise and eat well and less likely to engage in risky behaviors like smoking and drinking. So, now that we know what factors impact your life expectancy, is it possible to find out when you will die? There are plenty of lifespan calculators available on the internet that purport to calculate your date of death, like faithfulday.eu and deathclock.org. Let's look at a few examples from these calculators to see when you might die given your current age and some lifestyle factors. According to deathclock.org's calculator, a 15-year-old male born in the US who is of average height and weight doesn't smoke or drink, and is not depressed, can expect to live to the ripe old age of 80. The calculator actually takes it a step further and estimates their date of death to be Sunday, August 5th, 2085. A female with similar factors would live until age 85 or until 2090. However, a 25-year-old male who is an overweight smoker and a heavy drinker would only expect to live to age 61. Their date of death is calculated to be Thursday, August 3rd, 2056. A similar 25-year-old female would expect to die in 2056 at age 66. It's certainly spooky to have a calculator tell you the date of your impending death, but it's important to know that these tools are calculating average life expectancy for someone with your factors, but they can't really predict with any accuracy your actual date of death. If you really want to know exactly how long you'll live, it turns out that your DNA just might hold the answer. Scientists like Steve Horvath, a biostatistician at UCLA, are turning to DNA to see if the date of our death is written into our genetic code. Their findings are truly startling. Horvath has discovered an epigenetic clock in our DNA that's remarkably accurate at predicting when we'll die. His tool, called DNA M. Grime Age, can calculate whether an individual is aging at a faster or slower rate than average. If the tool shows that you're aging 8 or more years faster than your biological age, you have 2 times the risk of dying than the average person your age. If you're aging 7 years slower than average, your risk of death is cut in half. So when will you die? Thanks to science, you just might know the answer to that before you know it. If life expectancy has been on the rise, especially in the last century, does that mean that we can soon expect to live to the age of 100 and beyond? Well, not exactly. Some experts are actually concerned that the recent rise in obesity rates in developed countries will actually halt the trend of increasing life expectancy within the first half of the century. 5% of the US population is obese today, compared to just 1% in 1962. If this trend keeps up, we'll likely see a slowing of the trend of increased life expectancy, and we may even see a reversal, with life expectancy declining around the world. While this is certainly not great news, thankfully this is largely related to factors that we can control, such as diet and exercise. If more people begin to live a healthy lifestyle, we might just be able to correct this problem. It might not be possible to accurately predict exactly when you'll die, but science is definitely getting closer. We live in an age with the highest life expectancy in history, thanks to advances in medical care and lower rates of infant and child mortality. The average person today can expect to live almost twice as long as their great-grandparents did. And that's the good news, and it may be tempting to assume that we're on track to live forever. Unfortunately, the bad news is that this trend of increasing life expectancy might actually be in danger of reversing in the near future if we don't reduce rates of obesity and live healthier lifestyles. If humans truly want to be immortal, or at least live longer lives than their parents did, we have some work to do. If you thought this video was fascinating, be sure and check out our other videos, like this video called What Happens When You Die? Or perhaps you'll like this other video instead. As always, thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!